may be aware, the Buhari administration is moving the country away from a monoproduct economy to a diversified one, and in the process, opening up great opportunities for businesses and entrepreneurship. With the crash in oil prices, which has negatively impacted on our economy, we are left with no choice but to explore new possibilities. The areas we are targeting include agriculture, solid minerals, and creative industries. We're also engaging in massive infrastructure development. Agriculture is the first plank of our economic diversification and revival strategy. The Federal Minister of Agriculture is encouraging local production of rice, maize, sorghum, millet, and soya beans in order for the country to achieve self-sufficiency in these staples. Today, farmers in 11 of the country's 36 states are receiving credit support through the Central Bank of Nigeria. This year, one state alone, Kebbi, will produce over 1 million tons of rice. More states are joining Kebbi in rice production. The second plank is the massive investment in critical infrastructure like roads, power, and housing. We are pursuing alternative sources of power, including solar, hydro, thermal, and wind to contribute to the energy mix. We're engaged in massive reconstruction and rehabilitation. Of the 724 billion naira so far released for capital projects this year, 187 billion naira is for power, works on housing. Then there's railways, where General Electric is investing $2 billion in a concession. And of course, there's the solid minerals development, highlighted by the discovery of nickel in commercial quantities in the northern state of Kaduna, and the creative industries where the Ministry of Information and Culture, where I preside, has entered into a partnership with a number of organizations, including the Tony Elumelu Foundation, to develop capacity and put the industries in touch with the business world for mutual benefit. To encourage entrepreneurs like you and also bring in more investments, the administration is delivering its commitment on the ease of doing business. In fact, the president has approved the establishment of the Presidential Council on Ease of Doing Business in order to remove unnecessary red tapes and other impediments, thereby facilitating registration of businesses, clearing of goods from the ports, obtaining visa, paying taxes, and obtaining land titles, among others. The administration is also taking measures to reduce fiscal and forex imbalances, boost dollar liquidity, curb inflation, lower interest rate, and ensure lending to the real sector. With insecurity and corruption also being tackled decisively, the enabling environment is being created for businesses to thrive in the country. We hope when the time is ripe, young entrepreneurs like you will take advantage of these opportunities.
I am very happy for all that the, on a serious note, for all that the Minister of Information said about what government is doing. Because all those things he said, we need to do and do more, especially this time of recession. We have to make doing business in Nigeria very, very easy. Very, very easy. We have to create conducive environment for people to want to do business here. We have to invite them. We have to induce them. We have to make them wanting to come to Nigeria. And if we are not doing that, we are failing. You said we are doing that. Let us see the result of what we are doing. Now, a situation where somebody wants to come to Nigeria to invest, and it takes him or her 1 week to get Nigerian visa. It's not a way to do business, the easy way to do business in Nigeria. In other countries, they will get visa at the airport. I think we need to do more of that. We need to be able to register a company. We had one stop shop. What has happened to it? Let me just say one thing that I know, and I know very well. We have not taken advantage of all the opportunities we have for our small and medium enterprises to be able to produce and sell outside our shores. We have not. And you, if we don't do enough of that, those of you who may succeed may be frustrated. Let me tell you what I know. Agric and agro-processed products from Nigeria cannot enter the United States, cannot enter Europe. Even yam, ordinary yam, that is Nigerian yam, it has to go through Ghana to go to America. And you know why? They needed something they call certification center. Simple thing. Simple thing. We haven't got it. Ghana has it. And it doesn't take much to put that in place.